Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can write a Python program to display the calendar for a specific month of a specific year and for all the months of a specific year. And in the end, we will see how we can modify this program and display the calendar for the current month and also the current year. So here we will be using the calendar module. In this program, first what we do is we will import the calendar module and then we will ask the user to enter the month and year for which the calendar has to be displayed, and then we will display the calendar. So here first let's import the calendar module. So it will be import and the module name is calendar. Now we can ask the user to enter the month and year and we can take the user input. Here I will use the input function, and here first we will ask the user to enter the year. So I'm going to say enter the year. After seeing this message, the user will enter the year and this input function will return that value as a string value. Here we need the numbers in number format or integer format, and that's why I will convert the user input to integer form by using the int function. And then I will store it in a variable. Let's call it as year. Okay. Similarly, we can ask the user to enter the month value. So I will change the message here, enter the month, and the input function will return that value as a string value. We will convert that to integer and then we will store that in this month variable. Okay. So now we have the year and month for which we have to display the calendar. Let's display the calendar. To get the calendar of a particular month of a particular year, we can use a function available in the calendar module. And that function is called as month. For this function, we have to provide the year and month. So these values are present in our year variable and month variables. So this month function will return the calendar as a multi-line string value, and we can display that return value using the print function. So it will be like this. Okay, now we have written the program. Let's run this. Enter the year, I'm gonna say 2023. Enter the month, 5. Now you guys can see we have the calendar for the month May of the year 2023. Now, here we are displaying the calendar for the month. What if we want to display the calendar of all the months of a particular year? To display that, what we do is we will use another function available in the calendar module, and that function is called as calendar. So it will be calendar.calendar. Here, the first calendar is the module calendar that we have imported above. And then the second calendar is the function that will provide the calendar of all the months of a specific year. For this function, we have to provide the year value. So here, we can refer the value present in this year variable. Now here, we don't need the month variable. That's why I will comment it out. For this particular run, we are displaying the calendar for all the months of a particular year. Now, this calendar function in here, it will return the calendar of all the months of a particular year as a multi-line string value. So all we have to do is we have to display that using the print function like this. Now, here we have written the program. Let's save this and let's run this. Enter the year, I'm gonna say 2023. When I hit the enter button, I can see the calendar of the entire year. Now here in this program, till now, we are entering the year and month manually. Now what if we want to display the calendar for all the months of the current year and we don't want to provide that value as an input? The program has to automatically find out the current year and it has to display the calendar for all the months of the current year. In order to do that, what we have to do is first we have to find the current year, and we can do that by using a module called as datetime. So here we will import datetime module. And for this year value, instead of asking the user, the program has to automatically find it out. So here, as I said before, we will use this datetime module. So it will be datetime, that is the module name. And then we have to use a class called as datetime. So here the first datetime is the module that we have imported. The second datetime is the class that is present inside the datetime module. And after that, we can use the now method. And this now method will return the datetime object, which contains details about the current year, current month, current date and all. So from this datetime object, what we can do is we can extract the year value. Okay, so that's it. Now this program is finding out the year value automatically. Now I will save this program and I will run this. Now, as you guys can see, we have not provided any user input. The program has automatically found out the year and it has displayed the calendar for all the months for the current year. Now we will modify this program and we will make the program to display the calendar for the current month of the current year. Now, just like the way we have calculated the current year, we can calculate the current month. So I will uncomment this variable or the line which is getting the month value. Instead of taking the user input, we will make the program to calculate it automatically. Here we can use this particular method to get the current month also. So what I can do is I can copy this, I can paste it in here, and instead of getting the year, we can get the month value. Okay, this will provide the current month. Now we can't use this calendar.calendar module to display the calendar for a particular month. So we will comment this code and we will uncomment the code which will display the calendar of a particular month. Okay, so now if I run this program, you guys can see the calendar for the current month of the current year. Now one more modification, one last modification that we'll make here. Now here we are calling this now method to get the date time twice. We can make it only once. So to do that, we will say current date time equal to, and we can calculate this particular part in here. Okay, after that, we can get the year value by using the current date time variable. I will copy and paste it for month also. Now let's run this. You know, it will not make any changes. The program will display the calendar for the current month of the current year. So this is it guys for this video. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, then write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, do subscribe to the channel.